So many people have sent me little messages asking me, why would they be doing this? Why? If your theory is correct, why would they be doing this? And it's simple, folks. You have to go back into history to understand this. And you have to understand the human psyche and realize there are many different personality types, and some personality types only want money and power. And they will support a system that provides money and power to them. We saw it through Hitler, through Stalin, Pol Pot. Every dictator throughout history has done the same type of things. And we're seeing it unfold here. What's coming next? All you have to do is look back to what Stalin did about the starving people that he caused. He caused the starvation. Maybe in a future video, we'll get into a more thorough discussion on that. Hitler, he had youth groups working with him to do the dirty work for him. And that that new press secretary and her little entourage there, well, that's interesting. That's all I'll say. We need to actually do one follow-up on that presidential seal and all those things in the future. So we have updated the article, and we're moving on to the next stuff. But yeah, what we're seeing is a repeat of history. And because of that fact, depending on the different levels that it's happening on, it makes it very difficult. And remember, I talked about that fog of war. The reason they've inundated us with the amount of media on the COVID-19, everybody covers it to no end. It is the number one story running every night. It replaced the impeachment right after the impeachment. It is the current thing that the media wants you glued to. The virus, the tests, the coming vaccines. Operation Warp Speed. A lot of people made fun of Trump for using that. Oh, but he used it for a purpose, ladies and gentlemen. And I don't know if he actually came up with that, but if he did, it's brilliant. And I think in a future video that we'll get in more in depth on, we'll talk about what Operation Warp Speed really means. Because it's just the next step in what we've been talking about here. And all throughout the history of mankind, ladies and gentlemen, people have wanted power over other people. It's a fact. And if we are not willing to accept that there are people who will get into positions in government to work their way up, to then find ways to control the populations of either their state, their country, or the world, depending on how narcissistic and how power-grabbing they are. And the ones who really run things aren't even in the spotlight. Oh, we know of them. We've seen many of them. The Bill Gates, the Henry Kissingers, the George Soros, the Rockefeller family, the Rothschilds. Those guys have as much or more influence on the direction governments and countries go than their actual political leaders do. We see Obama, he's still gallivanting around the world, acting like he's some kind of political figure when he's out. Can you tell me why that is? Why did the Clintons continue their quest for more power after Bill left office? And you see Hillary, she's positioning herself to fall right in there. Joe Biden said he's going to pick a woman. For a long time, I thought it was Oprah or Michelle Obama. I mean, Hillary was sitting back there, but this would have been a really sly way by the powers that be to slip Hillary in to the presidency. They gave you a direct shot at her, and you didn't want her. You didn't want her. You picked the Trumpster. Took him a few years, but he's finally come around to that same agenda. And you can't tell me he hasn't. Signing that stimulus package was an overt admission on his part. Now, the Operation Warp Speed, which is, as we all know, folks, the end game there is vaccinations for everyone. And I just saw a post and it really bugged me today. That was one of the posts that just bugged me. Talking about how they have a flu vaccine. They don't have a flu vaccine. It's a shot. And you have to get it every year. A vaccine is something, folks, that is pretty permanent. And we're not going to get rid of any coronavirus because the term has been around since forever. The word novel just means new. They have a new coronavirus. Do you think a vaccine is going to get rid of that forever? We're never going to catch a cold again. We're never going to get a coronavirus again. And those tests, man, why are they pushing the tests so hard? Because they want a count on everybody? Well, they have a count. Strangely enough, they're doing it the year, or it's all happening. Of course, I believe it was purposely allowed to happen. Other people will poo-poo that. But it's happening the same year of the census. It's required by law, ladies and gentlemen, to fill out your census form. I've been postponing mine. I guess I'm going to have to do that soon. Don't want Uncle Sam coming knocking on my door, do I? You haven't been counted! You haven't been counted. Because that's all we are. We're just a number in the end. We're pawns on the chessboard. We're even less than pawns. Because pawns can be strategically used. For the most of us, we're just fodder. We're in the way. And until we do something to change it, and I don't mean going to protest your governor or your that doesn't work. When has protesting done anything positive for this country in the past 20 years? Protesting does nothing. They don't care. And if you're still fighting about who's better, Democrat or Republican, those evil Democrats, those bad Republicans, you're missing the boat at this point. Because they're all on the same agenda right now. They're all doing their work, their noble work, just like the healthcare workers that carried the little and ran and did the video and made the little dancing video with the COVID-19 corpse in the bag. Mm-hmm. Those honorable people, folks, they're just doing their good work. And if you become fodder in it, they don't have to see your face. They don't have to deal with you looking into your children's eyes, knowing that there's no food because of the current situation that has gone on. And then when they bring you to your knees, folks, when the food isn't there and you've run out at home because you haven't prepared. You've had ample time to prepare. You're going to have to run to them for food, just like the people in those long lines in Florida going to get food because they weren't ready. Many of us were telling you the supply chain was the most critical thing in all this. Back in, what, January? We had mentioned it. Back in January. Now we're in May. And here it is. You know, that goes back to what I said last hour or the hour before, that no one can see 2 feet in front of their face. This was all predictable, folks. Not because I have some magic ball or anybody else has some magic ball. It was your algorithms. Your algorithms, the way you do things, that brought us all to this point. Protesting is going to do nothing. Going back to work isn't going to solve the problem when the meat producers aren't producing meat and the ones that have meat are being told to kill and get rid of their, not for food purposes, just kill them off. Bury them. Why is that, folks? Do you think that it's happening by accident? Oops, we didn't know this was going to be a problem. Those are the smartest people on the face of the planet, right? Those are your elected officials. They couldn't see this coming. They couldn't have warned you in February to stock up on food over the next few weeks because eventually we were going to have this kind of problem. They didn't know that was coming. Of course they did. Of course they did. They are paid, not by you, but you as well. But they are, that's their job to know these things in the future. They were working on a bill in January while the impeachment was going on, folks. And that was the stimulus bill, the CARE Act. Might not have been named that at the time, but they were working on that. All before they told you about it. They made a big deal to you about it. In those first few weeks, they didn't even make a deal. Once you knew about it, they didn't even make a big deal then, did they? Once the impeachment was over, the media, malpractice media, just picked up on the next major item on their plate, which was an agenda item for a lot of people. You don't think Bill Gates is behind this nefarious situation? Please, event 201 in October the 18th, folks, was a simulated event that got them prepared, made them understand how things would all work out for this exact eventuality. That's right, folks. And if you haven't even figured that one out, if you haven't even figured that, you're so far behind that I don't even know how you're going to make it. And it's unfortunate. We're going to take a quick break, folks. The second half of the show coming your way.